They say what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, even when it could actually kill you. Enter belladonna, also known as deadly nightshade. It's right there in the name, a known poison, historically used against kings and armies alike. But it's also been used to do the opposite, to help people as a medicine. It's even been used for some risky beauty applications, which if you've seen our When TV Was Sexy video, then you know people do some weird things for beauty. Belladonna contains multiple tropane alkaloid compounds that have various effects on the body, but the star of this episode is atropine. Atropine can have dangerous effects. It can shoot up your heart rate, make it difficult to eat or speak, and cause hallucinations. But at appropriate controlled doses, it could be used to treat an abnormally slow heart rate or even counter the effects of other types of poisons. It might seem like all these physiological effects are unrelated, but they actually have a lot in common. Acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is a common chemical in the nervous system that lets nerve cells communicate with each other, also known as a neurotransmitter. It sends these chemical messages by binding to one of two receptors, nicotinic or muscarinic, named for nicotine and muscarine respectively, because these two compounds can also bind and activate these receptors. Okay, so where does atropine come into this? Atropine can also bind to muscarinic receptors. But unlike acetylcholine and muscarine, atropine does not activate the receptor. Molecules like atropine are called competitive antagonists, since they bind in the same location on the protein as the usual compound, but they prevent the receptor from doing its job. Atropine binding is reversible, but it can still cause problems while it's there, particularly since these receptors it targets are widespread throughout the body. Let's take a closer look at these receptors. Muscarinic receptors have 5 subtypes in humans, aptly, if not creatively, called M1 through M5. While all of these receptors are broadly part of the nervous system, each subclass of receptors has a specialized body system it plays a role in. M1, 4, and 5 are mainly found in the brain and other parts of the central nervous system. M2 is found in the heart, and M3 in the lungs, eyes, and GI tract. Are you noticing a pattern? All of these receptors involve body systems affected by atropine, either as a toxin or as a medicine. The effect atropine has on any of these systems depends on how much of it you're exposed to and the way you're exposed to it. If a small amount is injected into a muscle or given via an IV, it could target the right receptors to treat a low heart rate or counteract a poison. If it's in your eye drops, it will mainly dilate your pupils. So let's zoom in even a little further and check out the biology of how atropine is actually binding a muscarinic receptor. Here's atropine, and here's acetylcholine, the usual molecule or ligand that binds a muscarinic receptor. They don't look very similar, but atropine does a pretty good job of being an acetylcholine imposter. There's a little pocket on the surface of the muscarinic receptor where either of these molecules can bind. And atropine interacts with this pocket similarly enough to acetylcholine that it sticks, but differently enough that the receptor doesn't get activated by it. It's like when you need to use a computer at the library to study for a test, but you can't because someone's taking up the only free computer to watch YouTube. Unless it's Biozone, which in that case, let them keep watching. So this binding of multiple compounds to the same receptor, what we call promiscuous binding, is not exclusive to muscarinic receptors. For all known binders to a given receptor, there are probably many more that we don't even know about. Why is that? Well, it relates to something called the pigeonhole principle. This principle uses pigeons in a hole as a way to describe a common mathematical principle. Let's say you have X number of boxes and Y number of pigeons. If you have more pigeons than boxes, there must be some boxes that contain more than one pigeon. Now, back to proteins. The bioactivity database on PubMed reports about 8,700 known ligand-binding proteins, or receptors, and over 900,000 known compounds. Looking at these numbers, we see that we have a lot more pigeons than holes. This means there has to be receptors binding multiple compounds. In fact, the connections between these things can get pretty chaotic. When it comes down to it, there's no hard line between medicine and poison. They're all just molecules that can be used in many different ways. What can bind will bind. Nature is stochastic and redundant, and we're just picking out whatever patterns we can find in it.
Hundreds of years before we realized how diverse and useful the chemical atropine would be, doctors might have used its botanical source material in medicine, the highly toxic belladonna. If you want to learn more about the history behind this plant, check out the video I made on my channel, link in the description.